takes a lot of strength just to bend these by hand. I have nothing that steams them. I work straight from the tree, bend them, keep the shape, and go with the flow on what the basket's going to be. You know, it takes a lot of dedication, it takes a lot of patience, it takes a lot of practice. My name is Stephen Jerome. My native name is Ekian Salom. That's my Mi'kmaq name. I'm from the Yeskabigia First Nation, and I'm a ancestral black ash basket maker. Well, we've been making baskets since we were little kids growing up. My father, Francis Jerome, he was a great basket maker. You know, he was in a wheelchair. We were his hands and feet. We'd help him out. It was just a way of life. It's my identity. It's our identity, the family's identity of who we are. You know, we've got footage of my great-great-grandfather in 1939 making the same baskets that were taught to my dad, and my dad taught to me. My baskets are called the rib baskets. They're the ones that throw them off a car going 90 kilometers an hour and they'd be bouncing off of everything and you still pick it up and still go to work with it. You know, I work with black ash day in, day out. So we decided to call this the Ash Hole. The name of my shop raises eyebrows, but you know, if you say it right, it's okay. You know? We all have that sense of humor. This whole shop is like gifts from all over, people from all over. They drop off snowshoes, they'll drop off this, drop it in, send it, hey, I want to help decorate your place, and we'll put that on the wall. And I'll find places, you know, and I remember each and every person. So this morning, what we're going to do, we're going to go out, I'm going to take my niece, Shauna, and we're going to take my dog also. Yeah, my dog's name is Buzz. And we're going to go up river, up the Grand Cascabedia River, drive up with my boat, and we're going to go find some logs and transform that into baskets. I'm teaching her culture at the same time. I'm teaching her a whole bunch of stuff, and that's what she needs. She needs her identity back. Right there now, I'm teaching Shauna basket making, and she's right into the culture right now. She's a trainee, but she knows what she's doing. I've been teaching her for how many years now? A few years?
Yeah.
We're heading up the Grand Cascapedia River. We're gonna head up, let's say about a mile or two, and to go to my stomping grounds, where all the black ash are, all the good stuff. 100 years ago, they were here, on boats, on the ice, crossing the ice. It's year round. And the Mi'kmaq, in our language, is called the Wisco.
Wisco?
Yeah.
Does that just mean like
black ash? Wisco? Yeah. It's got a nice cushion. Perfect. Here's the layers I was talking about, the good nickel and dime widths right here. That's the age of the wood here. And there's going to be white gold right here. White's good. And brown will be also number one. Good quality. But even before I chop that tree down, I'm doing a little investigation on top to see if there's any branches that are peeling and stuff like that. Oh, you smell this, Shauna?
Is it a good one?
It's a good one. Smell that. The perfect smell about black ash tree, it has to smell like red wine, a little bit of sugar. Before I take it out of the woods, it passes all these tests, put it on my shoulders, bang, bring it out, bring it into my shop here, and we'll start transforming into little thin strips of ribbon for the ladies. Basket making is you know, very important to me, because my father always said, keep it going, because one day nobody's going to be making these baskets anymore. And he was right. My father died in 2002, 19 years ago. I've always promised him that I will keep it going. And 3 years ago, I kept that promise and I said, yeah, I'm going to be doing this full time. It's about why I need to stay here, stay home, and to teach. Teach all over. Teach my people. The project that we're running now, through the band office here, there's 12 elders that are making baskets right now, teaming up with the younger people to take their skills, transmitting them to the younger ones that don't know how to make, or they make them but need the skills of our elders. Well, the future of the basket making, it's all about education, teaching the younger ones, the next generation, and hopefully it just keeps on going. It steps and steps and steps. We have to keep the culture going, and I'm trying my best. Every year, I got more people making baskets, and I'll go to communities and I'll teach them how to make baskets also. And when I get back home, I get a phone call and I said, hey, I like to get some material. I want to keep going. I'd send them the material, whatever they need. That's victory to me. You don't become a great basket maker overnight, you know. I've been doing this 40 years and I'm still learning. But I have the patience to make almost anything I want to make, you know. I've mastered to pick in the logs, the black ash tree. I've mastered the preparation part, the bending part, knowing what the black ash can do with just your hands. With just bending of the hands, a vibration of the tree, everything you need, you have to master that before you can become a true master. I'm going on 17 years of sobriety, the drug and alcohol free, so I use it as therapy also. You know, and that's one of the habits I don't want to kick. And this helps me every day. My whole heart goes into everything I make. Basket making is life. I'm a basket case for life here in my ash hole. And just loving it. Just loving it.